Richard Dreyfus, there was a danger in Close Encounters, which of course you recognise, that you'd be swamped by all that wonderful machinery and special effects. What made you want the part so badly, in spite of that?
Because I thought, when I read the script, that it was the greatest film script I'd ever read, and I wanted to be a part of that project. I really didn't look at it, at least very intelligently, as an actor should. I just wanted to be in on this film.
Greatest film script in what sense?
I think it's an epic story. It is the most intelligent science fiction story ever written. I think that it, in a way that I don't want to sound too provocative, is important to the race, that the story be told and the way it's told. And for all those reasons, I want to be a part of it.
You've made a picture since, of course, called The Big Fix. What's that one?
It's a political detective story having to do with the radicals of the 60s and where they are now. It's a kind of comedy thriller.
Talking of comedy, I've also made one I love. I mean, I haven't had more pleasure from a film in 10 years than The Goodbye Girl, I didn't
think.
Thank you. This allowed you to develop the touch of comedy that's just about been glimpsed in other films, including Jaws and Close Encounters. Was it good at last to let it all hang out in terms of comedy?
Yes, for many reasons, theatrical and personal, that was the finest acting experience I'd ever had. It was tremendously fulfilling.
Is it harder work than straight stuff?
No.
It's very high-powered comedy, very energetic.
I could do that until I retire at 70 years old and they give me a gold watch.
What about the one you're making with Bob Fosse, All That Jazz?
It's a film about a film and stage director and his life in New York. And it won't start for about another 6 or 8 weeks.
Are you expected to live the life of a star in Hollywood these days?
Well, since I don't know what that is, I imagine I'm not.
Well, you've been to enough movies to know what it is. It's the big limousines and the Luella Parsons and the...
I think that stopped around 1938, didn't it?
Maybe I stopped around 1938. Richard, thank you very much.
Thank you.